Our first guest today is a next generation leader, a 34-year-old helping run a 37-year-old company with a market cap of 2.8 billion pesos or $56.5 million. His industry now at the center of a global shortage. Brian Leo of Cirtek Holdings Philippines, thank you so much for joining us. Finally, we have you on the show, Brian.
It's good to be here, Mimi. It's nice to see you.
Okay, so chip shortages, let's start with that. Lead times may be slowing, but the situation we hear is still quite dire. Do you think we've seen the peak, the worst of the shortage? And most importantly, what does this mean for your business, for Cirtek?
Not at all. I think this condition will continue on to around 2023. I mean, this is brought about by the growing pace of innovation of the world. We see demand for chips as not something cyclical anymore these days. Otherwise, it's actually becoming a way of life. So as technology becomes more harnessed and part of our daily lives, the demand for the components that create technology becomes more rampant. And this translates to the demand for such things like raw materials all the way to finished goods. And as we've been hearing these days, there's been a lot of bottlenecks in terms of logistics. But the way we can mitigate this is by having great partnerships with all our supply chain partners. And by having a diversified supply chain, we're able to manage our schedules and our shipments properly.
So are you saying that the shortage is not affecting your business?
It definitely is. It has caused a lot of delays, and it's caused a lot of pushback in terms of our scheduling. But the way we can make a workaround through the situation is by having a diversified supply chain. So by having good relations with our suppliers, we're able to schedule these ahead of time. And also through alternatives, we can find different sources to substitute those that are very much hindered by this logistics bottleneck.
So given all of these mitigating measures, your production timelines have not changed.
Well, production remains rampant, and we're continuously running the facility 24/7. So pretty much production has not changed.
Okay. But for the rest of the industry, Brian, what needs to be done, you think, for supply to pick up with demand? Is it a private sector issue, or is there something governments can also do?
Well, that's a really good view to take, because we're actually experiencing a renaissance of a period in the semiconductor and technology industry. What we're noticing is there's a huge, massive supply chain pool shifting, wherein a large demographic of which that used to be located around Southeast Asia is actually shrinking. So a lot of the factories that used to run prior to the pandemic have refused to reopen their doors even after the pandemic has pretty much been controlled. So that's creating a glut in the supply chain. And this glut is actually going to be transferred from the chip level all the way to the subsystems assembly, all the way to the finished goods side. So that's why it's going to be prolonged. But we think that this supply chain cringe is creating a renaissance of a period where premiumization for chips is actually being recognized these days. And as the need for semiconductors arise and stays inelastic, we think that this will continue further on.
Okay. So let's now get to Cirtek Holdings. How is Cirtek doing these days, almost 2 years into the pandemic? You mentioned that your facilities are still running hot. You had a pretty good first half, Brian. Profit was up, what, 60% to $8 million as revenue rose 8%. What drove that growth in the first half? And do you think you can sustain through, even beat that for the rest of the year, for the second half?
Yeah, so the growth was pretty much derived from the tailwinds in the semiconductor chip shortage. So this has provided us with the necessary tailwinds for growth. And we believe that this demand will continue onwards as more power management and RF devices arise. But of course, we were also caught flat-footed during the pandemic and delays in some of the arrivals of equipment has caused some of our expansion to be pushed back slightly. Mm-hmm. But due to the economic tailwinds, we were able to mitigate these delays by keeping production rampant and by being able to cater to our customers' demands. But as you know, Cirtek is a highly diversified company. And by being diversified, we have exposure in different key subsectors, not just in chips, but also in the subsectors like the subcomponents and all the way to full system assemblies of telecom infrastructure equipment. Now, by having a diversified portfolio, we tend to be over conservative. And by exposing ourselves to other sectors that may have dragged a little bit, this caused the outperforming subsegments that we have to be dragged on by these other slower segments. Mm-hmm. So moving forward, we believe that as the economy reopens, the deployment of telecom infrastructures will become more rampant and all subsegments will grow accordingly.
Mm-hmm. Just a quick question, which segments are outperforming and which are lagging behind?
So we're performing well on the semiconductor segment, mm-hmm. and this continues to enjoy economic tailwinds, as well as I think pretty much the world's needs for semiconductors. But as the world closed down during the pandemic, we noticed a slowdown on the deployments of antennas as well as other telecom infrastructure equipments. Mm-hmm. So that's caused a little bit of the drag overall. But we feel that there's good guidance on this side of the business as well, and things should ramp up pretty well.
Mm-hmm. The U.S.-China trade tensions resurfacing, Brian, will this have impact on your business? You're a global company.
Well, initially, it caused a shock to the rest of the industry. But what we're seeing is that this is also contributing to the shrinkage of the supply chain pool. Mm. And with that comes a renaissance of a period where semiconductors are actually enjoying a more premiumized rate. Mm-hmm. And as these are valued better due to a shrinkage in the supply chain, we believe that this should contribute further to a propagation of the semiconductor industry.
Uh-huh. That's a very positive outlook there. Brian, I know you're into tech. Cirtek is all about tech. Could you share with us some exciting innovations in your field?
Well, one thing I can talk about is RF devices, communication devices, as well as power management products continue to remain rampant. Mm-hmm. So as we see electrification of pretty much all devices across the board emerge, we believe that the translation and the propagation of power within a device will remain rampant, hence the need for more power management devices. And we've continued to harness new materials like silicon carbide and gallium nitride to be utilized in our new generation power management chipsets. And these are going to translate into better power efficiency as well as better power management within the device. As for RF devices, these continue to stay rampant as the need for data continues to stay rampant. And we've been amping up on RF chips as well as the connectivity and infrastructure of the world continues to evolve.
Exciting times ahead. Brian, big news. Last 2 days, the SEC has approved Cirtek's planned 3.5 billion peso preferred shares offering. How are you going to be using the proceeds? How long will the money last you?
Well, part of our initiative is to also grow the business. And of course, the growth of the sector and the industry as a whole is stated to continue for 2 to 3 more years, all the way to 2023 or 2024. But we believe that technology will become more a part of our lives rather than a cyclical thing. And with this, we'll need the resources for further expansion of capacity, as well as investment in new technologies to fold into our production capability. So the pace of evolution and technology is continuous, and the new generation chipsets continue to be hurled out into the industry. And even as we maintain mass production on a certain generation right now, the industry is already working on the next gen behind closed doors. Yeah. And that involves upgrading their technologies in order to stay in the game. Otherwise, you may be left out. So that's one thing we're doing with these resources, as well as expanding our sales network for the antenna business and pretty much improving on our R&D and technology.
Mm-hmm. Brian, I know that you've got a lot of things happening behind closed doors for the next gen, but very curious, for those who are watching who would like to know, where are your facilities right now? Are they mostly in the Philippines? Because a lot of your clients are abroad, are big telco firms in the U.S.
Yeah, so we maintain manufacturing for the semiconductors here in the Philippines. Mm. So that facility is located in Laguna Technopark and Carmel Rey, Laguna. But we have maintained some facilities as well abroad. So Quintel is based in Rochester, New York, and they have a sales network office in San Jose, California. So that's pretty much the key sites that we maintain. Mm-hmm. But you know, it's these chipsets, they're proudly made in here in the Philippines. And that is a great showcase of the talent here in the country. And I hope that with new administration coming in, this industry can be further improved.
Proudly Filipino made. Brian, final question. You did mention about next generation chips. Well, you happen to be a next generation leader in Cirtek. What's it like being, as we mentioned in the introduction, a 34-year-old helping run a massive business like this?
Well, I think there's a huge runway up ahead, and I think it's not going to be an easy runway to tackle. Which is why I hope that, you know, together with our team, we can continue to improve ourselves. We wish to actually contribute to the world as well. Mm-hmm. And as technology becomes more of a part of our lives, it is actually our honor to be part of this industry and to play a role in the evolution of innovation. Mm-hmm. As you know, as innovation prospers, the backbone that comprises this part of the world is comprised of none other than semiconductors. And in order to evolve, we need to keep an open mind in order to reach further. So, of course, you know, it's an honor to be part of this industry. It's an honor to be part of the exporters of the country. And we will do our very best to maintain this value and to exhibit Philippine resilience.
The last time we had an interview, Brian, I think was 3 to 4 years ago. And really, you've climbed up the ranks. I remember that time you were talking about Figaro and your other ventures. What do you think will you do differently from your dad, from Jerry Liu, who founded this company? How are you different from him?
So I have nothing but respect for our founder and our chairman, Mr. Jerry Liu, my father. I learned everything from him, you know, so I can't say that I can really outdo that. Starting a company all the way from the shores of Taiwan, coming here to the Philippines, I mean, not knowing a single soul and establishing this company is, that is something hard to outdo. So I don't think I can really outdo that, but what I can do differently is to respect the company that he's built and propagate the technology that he has established. Not just because it was founded by him, but because of the families and the other team members that help us get to where we are. So I owe it to him and to the families that helped us to propagate Cirtek into a higher progress. Mm-hmm. And that is part of that is to improve the technology, branch into new customer bases, and pretty much expand the sales network. Mm-hmm.
A new generation to take this company to the next generation. Brian, thank you so much for joining us today. Stay safe.
Thank you, Mimi. Good to see you.
Good to see you.